la minera. Come on down. And of course, we have the first gentleman of Tuskegee. Thank you so much for joining us. Our first lady.
Welcome you
to this meet and greet of the 8th president of Tuskegee University, Dr. Lily McNair. We're going to invoke the spirit of the Creator as Alumni Club Chaplain Curtis Rayborn offers the invocation.
Let us pray, please. Eternal God, our God, God of our weary years, God of our solitudes, thou who has brought us thus far along the way, we pause in this moment, O Lord, to say thank you. Thank you for this new president that you have installed here at Tuskegee University. Thank you for her leadership and the vision that she has for this institution, for our community, for our students, O Lord. We pray that you will bless her, bless all of this Tuskegee University institution. Crown us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, O Lord. Give us compassion one for another, but also compassion for those around us, O Lord. We ask that you would bless our giving, bless, O Lord, our time and our talents that we provide to the university. Show us, O Lord, how we can, through your grace, become better stewards of this institution. We ask it all in the name of Jesus Christ and for his sake. Amen.
Amen. And now we're going to move on, and we're going to have a musical selection for this meet and greet by Jamal Upshaw. Jamal, bring me in. Thank you. President of Tuskegee University, the first female president, Dr. Lillian D. McNair. Thank you very much. You know, today's meet and greet hour for the president, Dr. McNair, is a true testimony of the familiar saying, town and gown. We are here this afternoon, Dr. McNair, as a community, not just Tuskegee University, not just alumni, but as a community. For we are so pleased to have several entities and groups from our community. Now, I don't know where all of you are, but let's see, do we have any elected officials in our audience? Any elected officials? Would you please stand? Elected officials. Yes. Thank you very much, elected officials. Do we have any staff, administration, or staff, faculty from Tuskegee University? Would you please stand? All right. Included in the elected officials, I did see members of the City Council of Tuskegee, as well as members of the Board of Education of Tuskegee. Do we have any other groups? Do we have any other groups that we need to recognize this afternoon? Then everybody just wave your hand and say, I'm here. All right, everybody raise your, wave your hand. And now, we're going to go back for a few minutes to 1881. I'm trying to see if there was anybody around at that time. I'm probably the closest one to it. Maybe Freddie may have me on a few years. But it was 1881 when the history of Mother Tuskegee all began. And it began on what we Tuskegeans know as Zion Hill. I don't know, I get dated myself when I call it Zion Hill. We here in Tuskegee, we have communities. We have Greenwood community, we have Zion Hill community, and the like. Well, it all began on Zion Hill at the Butler Chapel, AME Zion Church. And Rufus Carson, one of my old schoolmates, a current steward of Butler Chapel AME Zion Church, is going to remind us of Butler Chapel and the Tuskegee connection. Steward Rufus Carson, thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Recognizing protocol, I come before you this evening and say we've come a long way, Father. We've come a long way.
Speaking of my peace.
When I look at where we come from, we can't deny our birthplace. Tuskegee was born in a little shanty on Zion Hill from the efforts of a lot of families there praying together and working together to develop a school in that community. No, Frank Nolan talked about the sociology of the community directing politics and the law. But we look at Butler's Chapel, and we had a pastor there named Solomon Beery, who tried to start a school and just didn't have the resources to succeed. They tried many times, but they failed. But God was in the plan. Those prayers were being answered. Louis Adams, superintendent of the Sunday school, was contacted by one of the representatives to get the black vote. Black men on Zion Hill had bought houses and were registered to vote. And that vote was important in the election of the representatives. This is not documented, but they say he gave Booker Washington $800 to come and pay at that school. Booker Washington came there, and again, God had the worst. During that time, the philanthropists in the country were helping blacks and other minorities to grow. And Booker Washington went around the country soliciting funds to help that school. You look at what happened, Solomon Deere tried for you people. Lewis Adams tried and made it. After that, the school began to blossom in all directions beyond expectation and move from Zion Hill to this present location. They built buildings and started a school that was known around the world. Let's not forget from whence we came. I think Mr. Cooper said that I had a time limit, so I was going anymore. But I'll say this to you, that we had a beginning on Zion Hill, and we have a new president now that an unprecedented occurrence, the first female president of Tuskegee University, is now here with us. And the challenge I put before her is this. We have a need for a leader with a vision. We have a need for a leader who will carry us to higher heights. Every Tuskegee grad knows something of a quality of excellence that is in all Tuskegee students, and we want to see this occur and come alive. As you matriculate here, we want you to build a direction for us, set a goal for us. We need that power to go forward, to make Tuskegee the pride of the good growing South.
All right, now. Thank you very much, Mr. Carson. Some very interesting historical facts about the founding of our alma mater, Mother Tuskegee. Thank you very much. It's hard to get a steward of any church to stay within a time limit, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Dr. McNair, before you arrived, I took the liberty of speaking from Maya Angelou on your behalf. And I'm going to return to the poem now and pick up where I left off. You would probably say, did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes? Shoulders falling down like teardrops? Weakened by my soulful cries? Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard? 'Cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I'll rise. You have risen as the first female president of Tuskegee University.
God instilled in her a desire to learn. So pursued her undergraduate degree in psychology from Princeton University and master's and doctoral degrees in psychology from State University of New York at Stony Brook. As her seasons evolved, she became a wife and mother. Now this young lady had multiple tasks, inclusive of her profession. You see, I believe that as God was molding Dr. McNair, he looked back over her life. He gave her the soft voice and mild manners of Fannie Smith, the first wife of Dr. Booker T. Washington. He gave her the desire to teach and educate as Olivia Davidson Washington, his second wife. He continued to cultivate her through her work in the community, based programs of our youth, gaining her recognition through funding from the National Institute of Mental Health and Center for Disease Control and Prevention. She continued to follow God's steps through other endeavors. Last but not least, she continued to gain the strength, fortitude, courage, ability to influence, power, and commitment of Margaret Murray Washington, who history states was the true leader of Tuskegee Institute. She was the wind beneath Dr. Booker T. Washington's wing, just as Dr. George Roberts is the wind beneath Dr. McNair's wing, as well as her lovely children, Randall and Marguerite. Well, as time in life has shown, the search committee made a call. Oh, what a glorious day. For Ecclesiastes says, to everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under the heaven. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and my honor to present to some and introduce to others Dr. Lily D. McNair as we celebrate her season at Mother Tuskegee. Dr. McNair.
Part of the university and the university part of the town. Somebody always asks me that question. What are your thoughts about working with the town? And I say to them, it's important, it's imperative. There's no other way that an institution can be part of a community without partnering with and working closely with people in that community. That's a part of the work that I did at my last institution, and I believe in it wholeheartedly and bring it here to Tuskegee. I have worked with Mayor Aguda. We've had several conversations since I arrived. We're on the same page, and we're working with others to bring resources to the town and city of Tuskegee and to the university so that we can partner together and move forward. And this is so important to us. And I think I'll say a little bit about this first before I go on to the other areas. It doesn't make sense for a university with the acclaim of Tuskegee to not partner with and be part of the beautiful city of Tuskegee. We have a rich history together, as Mr. Parsons reminded us. We've toiled together over the years. There's been courage that's been part of our endeavors. There is no way Tuskegee can move forward as a university without the city moving forward as well. There is no way possible for that to happen. We must align ourselves, we have to put shoulder to the wheel, and we have to be very, very committed to the success of each other. And I am here to do that work with you. I'm committed to bringing our students into the city to work on various projects, and I do know that there are some students right now who are working on rebuilding certain homes in the community, which I think is fabulous. And yes, it's fabulous. It's fabulous. And when I talk to the students, they are incredible. They say, oh yes, we measure all of the spaces in the houses. We order all of the building supplies. We go there every day, and this is part of our service to the community, and it's part of their commitment to the community and part of their academic experiences. That's an important way of having students really learn about, as Booker T. Washington said, we learn by doing, and our education is a combination of the head, the heart, and the hand. What better way for students to really demonstrate that type of experiential community at Tuskegee University than this project? So there will be more projects such as this coming forward for all of our students. Mayor Haywood and I have been talking with some groups about bringing new resources to Tuskegee, and we'll be sharing those ideas with you as they become more solid. But we are committed. We are committed to working together, to being part of a team. That's my commitment to you. When it comes to academic distinction, I'd like to talk to you about excellence in every way with regard to student success. We want Tuskegee University to focus on students being the center of everything we do. So we've made a high priority student success academically with regard to retention rates and graduation rates. We want the students who come in to Tuskegee to go through those 4 years as students and to graduate at the end of those 4 years. That's our commitment to student success. We want students to look back on their time at Tuskegee University and say, everybody here and there knows. This is a place that has high expectations for me. The bar is raised high. When the bar is raised high, the students achieve those results. And that's what we're doing here at Tuskegee. With regard to academic distinction, I am committed to finding resources to bring more faculty to Tuskegee who can work on multidisciplinary approaches. People from different areas. engineering and software. And yet, these are fabulous areas of interest and very high pride points for us. But there is other important work that our faculty do. Did you know that we have a biology professor who has received money from the National Institutes of Health to do research on breast cancer in African American women? And he has identified some of the important factors that lead to the high rates of breast cancer in African American women. We have this faculty member right here at Tuskegee, and he works with students in his research lab to carry out this research. That is phenomenal, both for students and faculty member and for the world around us when we think about the import of that type of research. Global education is critically important for all of our students. We know that when students travel to another part of the world and experience a new culture, they become transformed. They learn a lot about themselves, they learn about other cultures, but most importantly, they begin to think differently about how to be a member of a global society. We want all of our students to have this type of experience because the world is global now. We send students into a career, they start a career right after college, and before you know it, whatever career they're in, they're going to have to address global issues or travel and be part of the global community. Whether you're in psychology, whether you're doing research in engineering or chemistry or so on, there are always places where a global influence is going to be very important. And we want our students to have those types of experiences. So academic distinction says a lot about our students having important global experiences. The third component, philanthropic fundraising achievements, is all about bringing in money to the university so that we can carry out this important work. Everything that I've mentioned so far means that we need to find extra money, money that comes from external forces, whether it's from grants, or external gifts, or donor gifts, or alumni gifts, or so on. But I must focus on, with our management team at Tuskegee, on bringing in resources that will allow us, for example, to do the important community work that we want to do with all of you, that will help us to dream about the important work so that we can address the historical buildings on campus. Some buildings that were built by Booker T. Washington and George Washington Carver and their students over 100 years ago, which are in need of repair. We need external funds to address those. Alumni have said to me, we need external funds to improve the of their voting to focus on students' belief in moving forward, to help students to get through the registration process, the financial aid process, the housing process, and so forth, and do it with a smile. These are goals that I think we can all achieve together. And I'm looking forward to working with all of you here with regard to sustaining our wonderful relationship and making it even stronger. But I hope you can see from a little bit of the blueprint that I have, as I think about student success, academic discipline, and distinction, as well as exemplary customer service, as we look forward to Tuskegee reaching even higher heights. Excellence in every way is a demonstration of Booker T. Washington's statement, to do a common thing in an uncommon way is excellence. And I look forward to getting to know all of you through our meeting today and throughout our time here at Tuskegee. Thank you again for inviting me.
Let's hear it for Dr. Manners, Dean for Tuskegee University. Now, I wonder if there might be one or two individuals in the audience who would like to ask a question of Dr. Manners. Does anyone have anything you want to ask her? No one wants to ask Dr. Manners anything? Oh, all right, I have one brave. Oh, I thought you were going to ask a question. Dr. McNair, it seems that we have heard your vision, and I'm certain that we are going to support your vision in every possible way.
Thank you so much. That really means so much to me, Dr. Harrington. Thank you to all of you.
And be sure to call on Town and Gown.
I certainly
when you meet us.
I certainly
especially
will.
Town.
Thank you.
All right. Let's hear it again for the president of Tuskegee University, Dr. David Ryan. Let's hear it. Let's hear it. Jamal, I believe you are up. Let's see, where are we, Jamal. Yet, are you? Special presentation. Marjorie, come on around.
Doctor. On the numerous subjects that I heard you speak, your words have been profound. Positive, exciting, rejuvenating, heart-stirring. And there's a saying, the heart should not let the brain know what it's doing. And that's what happened to me when I greeted you after the ball convocation. I came up to you, shook your hand, and my spontaneous response was, Dr. McNair, I love you. Your presentation this evening is a repeat of your presentation before. We know that time is a precious gift that God has given us, and we appreciate the time that you will spend here during your tenure taking over Tuskegee. So, we have a token of appreciation. hope it will wrap him warm, as you have wrapped us in warm. Thank you.
Yes, special presentation to Dr. Lily Bailey. We also have another presentation before we go any further. Would you come forward, please, Mr. Oliver? He's here at the at Logan Hall Department of Athletics here. If there are any other presentations, you may come forward also.
First of all, I want to say thank you each and everybody for coming out this evening. You've shown force, you've shown leadership. On behalf of athletic director, Coach Willie Slater, assistant director, Jasmine Cox, myself as director of Logan Hall, my staff, we have a little something. Certificate of appreciation. Dr. McNeil, I'm gonna read it. Hereby given, Tuskegee University AD president, committed, dedication, impact, lives of others, has truly made a difference, and has given hope, vitality, and renewed encouragement to Tuskegee University. Our Lord and Savior God does not come and go at a whim, but his will lasts forever. He energizes those who get tired, gives renewed strength to those who are weak. For every young person may tire out, drop out, as you overcoats grow faint and weary. But those who wait upon the Lord shall have their strength renewed. They will spread their wings and soar like eagles. That's Isaiah 40 chapter 29, 31. The second portion of this certificate says, one tree can start a forest. One smile can begin a friendship. One hand can lift a soul, and one bird can frame a building. One candle can wipe out darkness. One laugh can conquer gloom. One life can make a difference, and you are that one. Let's give to Dr. Willie McNair, PhD. And then on the bottom line, and it reads, Tuskegee University has spoken. The Board of Trustees have spoken. Employees, faculty, staff, and students have spoken. The community leaders, sponsors, and supporters have spoken. This certificate of appreciation is hereby given to the Tuskegee University AD president, Dr. Willie McNair, on this 14th day of October in the year of our Lord, 2018. Signed, myself, Coach Willie Slater.
Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. What I want everybody to do, I want everybody to do is everybody please stand up for me. Everybody please rise. And I want y'all to repeat after me. One vision.
One vision.
One hope.
One hope.
One purpose.
One purpose.
One dream.
One dream.
Tuskegee University President.
Tuskegee University President.
AD President.
AD President.
Dr. Lily McNair.
Dr. Lily McNair.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Certainly an appropriate presentation from the athletic department after Tuskegee's win yesterday. Team Logan! All right, thank you very much. With no other presentations, I believe it is time for us to have another musical selection. Is it, Jamal? Are you on, Jamal? Yes. You on, Jamal? Come on down. Come on down. Come on down. Come on down. You're okay.
Well, this is certainly a surprise to me. I don't know if I'm here twice today. So I'm gonna do this about the
belt. It must have been cold there in my shadow. To never have sunlight on your face. You were content. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the shame. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle. For you are the wind beneath my wings.
Thank you, Jamal. Wind beneath my wings. Thank you very much, Jamal. This is Emma Brown. Would you come forward now at this time, the alumni treasurer and really the chair of today's meeting? Would you come? Thank you.
Good afternoon.
I would like to thank our 8th President, Dr. Lily McNair, for a wonderful presentation. We want to say thank you, thank you. We are looking forward to working with her and doing all that we can. We wanted to bring her out today so the community could see what we have to work with, so that we can get ready to get behind her and do all that we can for this university. I see that we have one of our trustees in the audience, Mr. Henry Davis. Again, we want to say thank you for our faculty and staff for joining us and giving us all the support that you have given us. Our Tuskegee Lowell alumni members, would you please stand? We want to say thank you so very much for you coming out and supporting us. We have Ms. Mary Hicks in the back, and if there's anyone that would like to join us today and become a part of the working crew, we welcome you. She is, will sign you up back there and let you know what you need to do to get started to work with us. Again, thank all of you for coming, and you will be hearing more from us as time goes on. We want you to come on and support us, and let's help Dr. McNair do all that she can for our university. And upon the blessing of the food and the closing remarks, we would like for the head table to be served, our special guest, and Mrs. Upshaw will further direct us as to the service of the food. Do have a good afternoon.
Before we proceed, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been very patient with us this afternoon, and we want to express appreciation to you. I know you're hungry, aren't you?
No, you're not.
Again, welcome Dr. McNair. As we revisit, we're going to revisit now the final message from Maya Angelou, as you would say. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my eyes? Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide, leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and hope of the slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. Dr. Meg McNair, you have risen as the 8th president of Tuskegee University. And now, please prepare to join in the singing of the first stanza of the Tuskegee song. The words will be found on, for those of you who have our program. And then we're going to ask Reverend William Jones, the retired pastor of Town Creek Missionary Baptist Church, to offer the blessing of the food and the benediction. And you will enjoy refreshments. Everyone, please stand for the Tuskegee song. Tuskegee, the pride of sweet roaring sound, we pay thee our homage today. For the word of thy teaching, the joy of thy care, and the good we have known in thy sway. O long-striving mother of diligent sons and daughters,
if you will, let us bow our heads for just a moment. Eternal God, our Father, we come now to ask you to bless the food that has been prepared for the nourishment of our body. Let it be, Lord, for our physical body. We ask these blessings right now in the precious name of Jesus and for his sake, and they said, amen.
Amen.
Let us prepare for and receive our benediction. Will the Lord, if you will, allow the road to rise up and meet us. Let the wind be always at our back. Let the sun shine warm on our faces and the rain fall softly on our field. We ask these blessings right now in the precious name of Jesus and for his sake. And they all said again,
amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. This is our benediction.
Amen. We will be guided in our prayer video. Let's just do a new. The head table, would you move down, and then we will be guided by the other villages. All right? Thank you very much. Feel free to meet and greet the 8th president of Tuskegee University. Dr. McNair, I think you should come down.